Hello everyone, I welcome you all to Geeky Script. Today I am going to show you how to install the latest version of WAMP, that is WAMP version 3.3.5 on a Windows operating system. And after that, I am also going to show you how you can easily create a simple Hello World PHP program and how to run that on our browser. So do watch the video till the end. I can guarantee if you watch the video till the end, you'll be learning a lot of new things. And if you still face any issues in middle, you can always ask me on our conversations. And I'm also on Instagram now, so you can always ask with all of your doubts, with screenshots and everything on Instagram. I'm always there to help you. So now to install WAMP, you need to first simply go to favorite browser and to search over here, WAMP Server download, and hit enter. So that's going to show you the sourceforge.net link, the second link. So you have to click on this WAMP server download, and it's going to redirect to the official site of sourceforge.net. So this link I'm going to provide right in our description. So once you are here, you have to click on this download button, and immediately you will see telling that your download will get start shortly. So within 5 seconds, it's going to start downloading our WAMP server. You can see that it is rightly started downloading WAMP server version 3.3.5. So I have already downloaded it, so I'll cancel this. I'll minimize my browser. I'll go to my download directory, and here you can see that our WAMP server version 3.3.5 is already been downloaded over here. So to install, just simply double click on the exe. It will ask you for administrative privileges. Click on yes, and there you go. So here you need to select one language. So I'll select English, click on OK. So these are all license agreement, you need to accept it, click on next. Here also need to click on next. But you can see it is giving some error. So all these Visual C++ packages are missing. So that's why it is, you know, throwing this error. So you need to install these C++ packages first. So you need to download it. I'm going to show you everything on this video itself. You don't need to worry anything. So first thing that you need to do is you need to go to this wampserver.aviatechno.net. So just go to your browser, open a new tab and type wampserver.aviatechno.net. So hit enter. So this link again I'm going to provide right in your description. So once you are here, you need to scroll to till bottom, and here you can see all different Microsoft VC++ packages are available, right? So Visual C++ redistributable packages. So now you go back to your error again and see which packages are missing. For your case, you might see, you know, more packages that are missing or less packages that are missing. Whatever it is, you need to identify the error and then you need to download that package. So for example, I need to download this Visual C++ 2012 x86. So here if you see 2012 x86, so you need to download this. So just click on that, you can see it is directly downloaded. The first one is downloaded. Next is Visual C++ 2010 sp1 of x64. So this one, 2010 sp1 x64, click on the link and that will also get downloaded. Similarly, the third one is Visual C++ 2012 x64. So 2012 x64. So this one, 2012 x64. Click on the download link and that will also get downloaded. Now it's time to install all these three different packages one by one. Let's first minimize our browser and close this installation of WAMP first. Yes. Now these three are the packages what we need to install. So let's start with the first one. So accept the license agreement, install. It will ask you for administrative privileges. Click on yes, and that is also done. So it is done now. Close it. Now let's install the next one. Double click on it. Accept the license agreement. Accept the license agreement. Click on install, and there you go. So this is also done. Click on finish. Now let's install 2012. Just double click on it, accept the license agreement, install, click on yes to provide administrative privileges, and that is also done. Close. So all these three different packages are now installed. So now you are good to go to install our WAMP server all over again. Just simply double click on the exe. It will ask you for administrative privileges. Click on yes. Choose language English. Click on OK. To accept the license agreement, click on next. Next. And now you can see it is no longer throwing any error. So you are good to go to install our WAMP server. So this is how our WAMP server is going to be installed. So on our C directory, it's going to create WAMP server 64. Totally fine. Click on next. And it is ready to be installed and it is rightly started installing. So let's wait for a couple of minutes. So by the time our WAMP server get installed, I'll request you, please do subscribe our Geeky Syntax channel. Here also regularly I'm posting lot of coding related videos. So please do subscribe this channel, that will really motivate me to make more and more this kind of videos. And also if you're interested, you can also subscribe our Geeky Script blogging channel. So let's wait for some time. So we'll come back. And now you can clearly see that a WAMP server is almost installed and it is telling whether you'd like to use this Edge, Microsoft Edge, as your default browser for WAMP server. If you want to change it with some other browser like Chrome or, you know, any other browser, you can always click on yes and you can point to that browser. In this video, I'll keep it simple. I'll use Edge only, so I'll click on no. And same thing it is asking regarding Notepad. I'll again keep it default, so I'll click on no. So I'll keep it simple for this video and it's going to finish installing our WAMP server within 30 seconds, you can see. And it is rightly done. So click on next and finish. So our WAMP server 3.3.5 is rightly installed. You can minimize your download directory. And here also you can see that our desktop shortcut for WAMP server is rightly created over here. So all you need to do is, you know, to just simply double click on this desktop shortcut. It'll ask you for administrative privileges. Click on yes and it's going to start our WAMP server. So if you click on this icon, you will see that our WAMP server is currently red. So it's going to soon turn into orange and then it's going to turn into green. So you can see it is now green. So our WAMP server services is successfully running, right? So that in this way you can install WAMP server, you can start your WAMP server. Now I'll show you a simple code. So I'll go to C drive and you will see WAMP64 folder on our C drive. Just go inside that folder and here you'll see this www folder over here. Just go inside that folder and what you need to do is you need to create PHP projects under this directory called www. So this is the folder for WAMP server. So any PHP project that you want to create that need to be resides in this directory, alright. So just right click and hover over new and click on folder to create a new PHP folder. So let's name this folder as hello world. Go inside that folder, let's right click and create a new text document and let's give the text document as hello world dot php. So I'll remove this txt and I'll keep dot php only. Click on yes. So if you are unable to see this type of file name extensions, for that what you need to do is you need to click on view and then need to hover over show and then need to enable this file name extensions. So once you enable this, so you can see a tick mark icon over here. So once you enable this, we'll be able to see this file name extension, that is .php or .txt or .java. So you know, all these different languages has their own file name extensions. So that is what you need to give, .php. Now let's open the file in a notepad and write a simple hello world code snippet over here. So angular bracket php, end the angular bracket and just simply echo something like hello world. So hello world. So just go to file and save this file. And now if you go to your browser and just type localhost, give a slash and then you need to provide this folder name which is hello world, right? So on our www folder we have created this project called Hello World. So that same thing is what you need to type over here. Hello World. Alright, so just hit enter. And that's going to show you whatever is there within this folder. So if you double click, so in this folder we have a helloworld.php file within this folder. So that is what it is showing over here. So under parent directory you can see helloworld.php file. If you are having any other file, so that files also it should be showing. So now all you need to do is to just simply click on this file to get the output hello world on our browser. So whatever code you have written, so whatever thing that you want to echo, so that output should be coming on our browser when you run that on our browser URL in localhost. So that was possible because our WAMP server was running, and that's how you run any PHP projects using WAMP server. So that is basically all about this video. Please do consider subscribing our Geeky Syntax channel along with Geeky Script vlogging channel. That's going to really motivate me to make more and more this kind of videos. So that's basically all about this video, friends. Thank you very much for watching this video, and God bless you all.